What's going on?
Listen, you can't give up.
Hey, good seeing you again.
That's been after our potential recruit is nearby. You could hack their optic to erase all the intel they've gathered. I'm sure the person we're tracking would be quite glad to see them dealt with. All the intel has been wiped. That should set SIRS back a bit. I'll inform our prospect. Now that you've helped them, they might be willing to talk to us. Recruit has been trying to bring an Albion war criminal to justice. We should be able to download their full record off their optic. A complete service record from the guard's optic, including one particularly nasty atrocity. I'll send it on to our prospect and let them decide how to handle it. We're being contacted by our potential recruit. Patching them through now.
Anything you need, just say the word.
Forget it. You want to return the favor? Join DedSec. We're always looking for good people.
Sounds like a blast. I'm in.
Oh, God! What the fuck?
Control to all units. Possible hostiles near your location. Received. Watching for suspect.
Anyone have visual? Anyone?
Suspicious activity. Together,
we can pick them up. Return into HQ. Search terminated.
Hold on to this.
Thank you.
wait around and see if our dance opponent shows up.
We are keeping you safe.
Based on their social media rantings, our prospect won't respect anyone who can't beat them in a game of darts. Which I suppose is perfectly doable, even if it is a bit low stakes.
Imagine how... And you want some of this? They'll never know what...
You play darts? I need the practice.
I'm gonna beat you, no doubt, mate. A god.
Thank you, I suppose.
Don't you walk away from me. Can you believe this?
Stop, shut.
Is everything on your shite?
This is London Calling. I'm Pat, and you're listening to Buckingham. Your source for what you're doing.
I'll get you next time. I'm serious.
Damned arthritis.
Come on!
Just like riding a bicycle. Try and top that. Go on, I dare you.
Oh, well, better luck next time.
Do you play darts or what?
You're on, you cheeky bugger.
Now I'm really cheeky.
What, you lost your
nose? That's the blood wasn't fucking on. I've seen a lot of nose.
I'll get you next time. I'm serious.
In this episode, we're talking about CPOS-3.0, the city operating system that's now powering all of London. For those of you who live in London...
Come on! I'll get you next time. I'm serious. Come on!
Son of a bitch, bastard!
Come on! Yes!
Damned
yes! I won!
deputy.
Can clear a potential recruit's arrest warrant from a nearby terminal. There's the terminal. You can clear the warrant from there. Potential recruit is now officially off London's most wanted list. Now that you've helped them, they might be willing to talk to us. Thank you. prospect has been trying to slip some jailbroken optics under Albion's nose. We could help them out by making the delivery.
Possible hostile at your location.
Control, we are ready to engage.
Use a pursuit intervention technique. Control, I've lost sight of the target. Oh. Over.
Drones are en route to suspect.
Negative. No visual of the suspect.
Calling off the pursuit. Over and out.
Source for what they don't want. I'm Tash, and this time we're giving a special shout out from us to the boys and girls at the Signal and Intelligence Response Service, better known as SIRS. Why not? They're going to be listening anyway. They're listening to everything. But don't worry, we're not going to say anything bad about a massive unaccountable fire that uses its powers to stifle dissent and shut down free speech. Instead, we're going to look at how SIRS became so powerful. And as usual, we'll keep everyone's names and locations secret, so SIRS doesn't come looking for them. Ian was a veteran political writer and podcaster back in the days of pre-crisis Britain.
The world we're living in now, fashion.
License.
Well, this is what fashion.
Mom!
Nightmares of my daughter. Wake up in a sweat.
The whole of jailbroken optics has been safely delivered, more or less. I'll tell them to come pick it up. We're being contacted by our potential recruit. Patching them through now.
I'm in your debt.
Forget it. You want to return the favor? Join DedSec. We're always looking for good people.
Hey? Yeah. All right.
Oh, mate, this is massive. I never thought we'd get this kind of reach.
What do you mean?
It's fucking Stormzy. You know, Bossy Bop. Shut up. Bloody Glastonbury. The man sent us a message and he's asking for DedSec by name. We're in the big times now, mate. We got us a fucking high-profile contract right here.
Wicked.
I'll send you the message. And for the love of fucking God, do not cock this up.
What's good, DedSec? Here's the word, yeah. Sir's been after me for ages, blocking my channels, shutting down every stream I open, and closing my fucking bank accounts. I made my career calling out those in power, and now they want to stop me. I got this new track, it's crazy, and I'm going to lay it down right here, then we're sending it out worldwide, bigger than anything you've ever seen. But I need your help. Sirs know we're here. They killed our connection to the servers outside, and no servers means no show, and everyone needs to see what they're doing to us in London. Treating us like savages, like cannon fodder. Fuck that. Let's do this together.
Fuck. We've got movement back here.
Shit. All right, let's roll.
You heard, Mr. Ormsey. DedSec has a role to play in this. Now backdoor Albion's servers, and let's get this illegal show on the road.
Shout out from us to the boys and girls at the Signal and Intelligence Response Service, better known as SIRS. Why not? They're going to be listening anyway. They're listening to everything.
Bellagio has been snooping into Albion's affairs. Quietly, of course, but I've been able to determine that most of his activity stems from this area.
Time to meet this mystery man.
Not so fast. Hamish isn't in, according to his home security. And before you get ideas, he's rigged his front door to a series of traps designed to delete all of his data and then your life. Not necessarily in that order.
Paranoid. Can't blame him.
To be fair, you are an armed insurgent trying to break into his flat. Anyway, you should be able to connect to the local grid and use security cameras to disarm his traps.
Noted.
Interface is on the rooftop.
Hey, there's a window up there. What do you think?
Sure, if you can get there. Three options here. One, use the window washing platform. Two, find a cargo drone. Three, give up, go home, and resolve to be a better person.
On it.
Thank you.
Not very inviting. The whole place is wired.
You could force the traps to unlock by rewiring the power.
On it.
Welcome to clear and present danger, and welcome to fascist London. Don't let that boot on the back of your neck disturb you. In time, you'll barely feel it. We have to wake up, people. If there was a playbook for setting up a totalitarian police state, Albion would be most of the way through it and working on the epilogue. They certainly took advantage of the fallout from the bombings, didn't they? Preyed on the fears of the city government, too. They were only too happy to hand Nigel Cash the keys to the city. Wash their hands to the whole mess. The collar will only get tighter now, friends, unless we do something. We can't wait for someone else to fight back. We are the change.
Are disarmed. Now, if you go through the front door of the flat, it's much less likely you'll be killed.
Never forget who they are. They are nothing better than henchmen. They are not here for the people. They work for their bad guys.
What a coincidence running into you again.
With you in it.
Chill, no need to get excited.
Who the fuck are you? And what are you doing in my flat? You with Albion?
No, we're more underground.
What, DedSec? Yeah, right, and I'm Che Guevara. You're done.
Listen, you're wasting time. Right now, you've got to run. Albion's coming.
Fuck me. You're telling the truth, aren't you? Fucking hell, thought I was careful. Fucking idiot, Amish. Look, Cass is worse than you know.
Oh, thanks. I know. Why else would I be risking my ass here?
Maybe, because Nigel Cass is paying you. That's how fucking mercs work.
Oh, come on. Not a friend of Cass here. We need your help taking him down, all right? He's behind the bombings.
Mate, you don't know shit. You have no idea what Cass is and what...
Move!
Fuck! An Albion squad's closing in on you. Guess you weren't lying about that part. Fuck. Think, Amish. Think. Shit, fine. Your table. I'll buy you some time. Just go. No!
Just stand there. Albion won't be fussy about who they shoot.
Oh, shit.
Is that a person I hit?
Over.
Over.
Putting an end to the chase now.
Auto drive now enabled.
Immobilizing the suspect.
Auto drive now disabled.
We are inbound. Stand by. Control, we are pursuing the target. All units force this suspect to stop.
Is done. The tone bombing presents us with an excellent opportunity. Once we've taken full possession of the site, it gives us a good vantage point on the Thames and provides us with a cover of activity to mask some of our own higher risk activities.
Control, put out an APW.
I think all that excitement convinced our new friend Hamish that we need to work together to tackle Cass. He's willing to cooperate.
Hang in there.
What am I supposed to
do? All right, Chief. That was a pretty slick escape. I believe you. So I'll say this. Nigel is planning something. And I don't think I could stop him on my own. If DedSec's everything I've heard, you'll help me.
We can help each other. There's a chance Cass had something to do with the bombings. What could he be planning that's worse than that?
No, that's not like him. Well, not exactly. See, Nigel's got to see himself as the hero. He's an arrogant twat, but he's not a cynic. Every place we go into, we would have some mad plan to fix all his problems. With robot police or automated crop fertilizing and some shit. Society was a technical problem. And people are just bugs in the software, you know? You work around them or you squash them. Sorry, Chief. I gotta switch proxy servers so they don't trace me. I'll hit you right back on voice.
Listen, I've got an inside man, right? A contact in Albion. Says Nigel's got this big meeting happening at White Tower. He'll be talking about a major project he's got planned for London.
What we need is an insider on the team.
I've always wanted to be in on it, Caper. Okay, first things first. We'll need eyes on the impregnable target, so off you go. I'll crack on with assembling the right personnel to round out this ragtag bunch of misfits.
Ah, shit. I'll be in cyber security sniffing my proxy IP. Must have traced the detonator signal. I've got to deal with this.
London? That place is totally locked down. How do we get in?
I'd like to help, fam, but Nigel's caught a whiff now. Before the CTOS cameras, it'd take him less than 5 to ID me. I ain't risking my pretty face.
We need an Albion insider for our caper, one who's willing to turn coat. I've reached out to a contact who works in a nearby pub. Where better to find a bleakly disillusioned anti-hero numbing their conscience with drink, but secretly desperate for redemption? I've let our contact know what we're in the market for, and she's nearby.
You lot certainly know how to pick your targets. You do know that Albion have set up their headquarters in there, right?
Yeah, I know. But go big or go home, right? And it's not like we have a choice. Cass is presenting his secret project to a bunch of dickheads. And I'll bet you anything, it means bad news for us.
Fucking Nigel Cass. You're right. Nothing good can come of this. Luckily, I hear loads of sob stories working in a pub. And near this place, quite a few from Albion are dissatisfied with the status quo. You turn on the charm, and I'm sure you can get one to join the good guys. Even got a candidate in mind.
Cool. Send me all the info I need.
I'll have Bagley push it along. Good luck, love.
We have an Albion operative on our roster. We should let them know they're needed.
The more we are, the better we are. Welcome to DedSec.
Yes, well, I'm ready to help however I can.
Wicked.
Nigel Cass's meeting will begin soon. Approach the Tower of London when you're ready. If we're lucky, word hasn't spread that you've hung up your jackboots. Just try to put on your meek, harmless, broken-by-the-system face. Oh, and don't forget your uniform. Looking sharp. Your ex-colleagues won't pay any attention to you unless you let them take a close look.
For Friday, mate. Simmons. Do you know him? Anyway, no matter. He's the one who organized our team-building activity. He's rounded up a few of the prisoners they brought in a little while ago. The ones who didn't have any relatives. He figures he'll make for an easier time when we declare them missing. Right. So the fun part. He's gonna release them into an open field while we get our shots in. I'll bet you a pint I can get rid of 10 before you. You're on, you slimy bastard. Listen here, I'm going to tell you something, and it's between you and me, completely off the record, yeah? The whole thing's quite disturbing to me. They've got good reason to close off parts of the building, but at the end of the day, it's a load of bollocks. This place is a treasured part of London's history, of its culture. Great, powerful men have ruled over this fortress.
Now we're inside. Any disturbance in here and Nigel Cass will surely cancel his meeting. Avoid being detected by your former colleagues or this operation is a bust.
Nigel won't have anything important on this floor.
You're quite knowledgeable about Cass, aren't you?
Yeah. I was Albion too, if you hadn't tweaked to that. Me and Cass were close once. Looked up to him. He was bigger than life, fam. Literally a tech genius, and I was just a gearhead kid. I wanted to be like him. That's why I joined up.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
Didn't find out he was a murderous prick until later.
Everything is proceeding under control. Mr. Cass is
to deal with construction.
London is at war against crime. Albion is here to protect you. Help us. Collaborate. And together, we will conquer.
I know.
know, Director Cass is a genius engineer, but everything he designs is weaponized.
I know, he's a little obsessed, but he's trying to keep people safe in this day and age. That is what he's doing.
End of the day, I think he's a shit. He's shit.
Nice, that's a shit. Maybe a little too much.
And they're just awful people. They are.
I'm sorry.
I agree.
This door clearly requires a security pass.
Well, that's just great.
Use one of the nearby computers to create your forgery.
Be careful. You don't want to know what Nigel does with trespassers.
Director Cass, I've been unable to reach the Commissioner's office.
He's stalling. Doesn't matter. It won't change anything. I won't allow it to change anything. Damn him. Yet another fool who knows what the right thing to do is, but lets emotions get in the way.
He's still scheduled to attend. Would you like him removed?
No. Despite all, we need to work with the official government to send a security detail to make sure he attends, dress it like a state privilege, and sit him front and center at the meeting. He'll be key to my getting the others to fall into line.
There's some parts of the city that need a good working over with some heavy boots. You understand?
Yeah, I know what you mean. But there's always an element that's going to resist all, right?
Sure, but they're taking care of them, none of them.
You mean dead set? I've heard some talk on the street that they may be back in operation, but I'm not putting much stock in that.
I'm not sure. There's some rumblings out here.
Signs that we need to watch out for. Well, they are out there and stirring the pot. I'm betting Director Cass has got a plan.
I haven't heard any new details about it.
I'm just sick of all these drones.
It'll take some time for the forgery to be ready. To keep you occupied, I dragged up still images and a recording from an internal investigation into Cass Senior's death.
Show me.
Internal psych assessment, AS-001, subject Cass Nigel. Mr. Cass experienced a deeply traumatic event when he witnessed the murder of his father, Gareth Cass, CEO of Albion. He began exhibiting symptoms soon after what he frequently described as the random event. Mr. Cass's initial symptoms included insomnia, paranoia, distorted blame, and recurring flashbacks. However, he appears to have channeled his anger and self-described powerlessness into his work to ensure that Albion become, quote, a mechanism for preventing unpredictable violence. It seems somewhat of a mania, edging on psychosis. For me, this raises concerns about Mr. Cass's fitness to run a multinational security company. But I cannot, at this time, make any recommendation beyond continued monitoring, especially considering that I have been asked to close this file.
Grand. They put someone incapable of processing their emotional baggage in charge of our security. Just grand.
Yeah, well, Nigel was never close to anyone but his dad. And me, I guess. Never had much faith in people, really.
Well, the pass is ready, but rough. If this resistance thing doesn't work out, I doubt you'll make a living as a document forger. Let's give it a go anyway. Nigel Cass awaits.
I'm communicating when I'm on there. I'm taking in art and culture.
You know they give you cancer, right?
Addicted to fentanyl.
You know,
signals.
I know. Really say they're safe. Come on, you believe that? It's like walking around inside a microwave. I swear I was just going to drop there. Just
one on the side before you.
tent.
I'm not saying it was.
How are you getting on with those metrics?
You know.
The deadline is coming up quickly. It wouldn't do to miss it. He's presenting to the stakeholders right now.
I know, but if I mess this up, then the whole project